I had a conversation with a friend a while back, and we were talking about slower balls. But the real conversation was whether it should be one word, which is how we pronounce it, slower balls, or as it's written down, slower balls. But either way, once we started using the term slower balls, we did kind of pigeonhole them a little bit. For instance, when England decided whether they wanted Benny Howe or not in their team, one of the reasons they decided against him was there wasn't much differential between his top pace and his bottom pace. They were looking for actual slower balls. And instead, Benny Howe gave them a bunch of balls that were more or less the same pace. His slower balls just weren't slow enough. And if you aren't as obsessed with Benny Howe as I am, you may not be aware that even though his slower balls don't have a dramatic pace drop, they still work. In fact, they work so well that this is all the bowlers in the last 7 years with over 120 wickets. This is where Benny Howe is, and here is Rashid Khan. Now, Benny Howe might actually be the king of slower balls. He claims to have 50 of them, not like all at once, but some are in various stages of development. But while he's seen as a slow medium pacer, he's actually more like a fast spinner. He hides what he's about to do, and he mixes up the variations almost every ball. So Howe is taking wickets not by changing the pace, but by changing what the ball does on the way down. And he had a very good 100. And so did someone else who is completely different to Benny Howe. Recently injured, Tamal Mills. He's the opposite of Benny Howe. He's left arm and fast as hell, and he has one slower ball that he generally bowls. This is something that Kartikeya Manchala has been making. He calls them speed distribution maps. There are essentially two pace bowlers. They have two different peaks, one at their top speed and then a bump on their slower ball. And Mills is one of them. But what makes him more interesting is his range. Sandeep Sharma's most used ball is in his 120s, and his slower ball is around 111. Mills' top speed is mostly around 142, but his slower ball is 107. He probably has the biggest pace differential in the world, although Ulrich Nolkia is now fighting for that title. But Mills can approach 160 kilometers per hour, and he can bowl around 95. So Mills can lose 38% of his pace from ball to ball. Think about this, because Howe bowls almost every ball around the same speed, and Mills veers between being one of the fastest bowlers on earth to a nippy spinner. They are both slower ball bowlers, but they are completely different in speed and skill and what they do. And so what it shows you is the real variety within slower balls. But the way we talk about them isn't always right. Like, for instance, sometimes you'll hear a commentator say, is their slower ball too slow? They don't really mean, is it too slow? What they mean is there anything on it? So even though Mills' deliveries are slower than, say, Rashid Khan's, hitting it is still really hard despite that pace. And that's because there are four main parts to why it works. Mills' slower ball is a back-of-the-hand delivery, which is basically a wrong-in. That means that when it comes out of the hand, it actually goes up a little bit. And then you get massive revs on the ball from the wrist action. So if you put together the arm speed and revs that Mills does, your first instinct when batting is that the ball is going to be coming at your head. That actually takes quite a while for people to get over. Here's Simon O'Donnell making Doug Bracewell's uncle duck when he gets bowled. O'Donnell's the man credited with making this ball an international sensation back in the 80s. And you can see when the ball is halfway down the wicket that it's still not actually bounced yet. And then suddenly Bracewell's uncle thinks it's going to hit him. He ducks, and it ends up going under his bum and actually bouncing before it hits the stumps. Essentially, back of the hand slower balls drop and don't land where you expect them to. But all that spin doesn't just drop the ball. When it hits the pitch, it actually kicks up more than any other slower ball, meaning that it can beat you on the bottom or top edge depending on where it lands. And then because it is so much slower, and you have to be prepared for a ball nearly 100 miles an hour, to be able to hit this ball, you have to keep your shape for a very long time. And that's not easy. But there is one really easy thing when it comes to the back of the hand ball, and that's picking them. The only slower ball that is really hard to pick is the knuckle, which has their own magic energy anyway because there is no rotation on the ball. It is the only delivery in cricket or baseball to do that. Bowlers hide their knuckle ball by changing their grip and their gather, meaning that batters often don't see it. Just a quick shout out to Simon Dool, Quick Wrist Spin and Cricket with Ash, and Raul, our animator, for helping me out with this footage. But despite the common phrase that we use in cricket that someone has not picked a slower ball, almost all professional batters can pick them. Here are the main three slower deliveries outside of the knuckle. So on the left is the back of the hand delivery that we were talking about with Mills. Now, I'm no professional batter, but I reckon I see some pretty strong signals that this is a slow ball. Like, this is what you should see, or at least some version of it. And in this animation, you can see as clear as anything that the two fingers are not behind the ball, but in front of the ball. Now, let's be really honest. We have animated this and frozen it, and the ball will never be this white. It will never be this clear. Plus, the 95 miles an hour arm speed is going to make it a lot more fun. But the point is that almost all professional batters should be able to see these fingers at the front of the ball. Plus, they will also know what the bowler's variation is. Outside of bowlers like Benny Howell, it's very rare for a bowler to actually deliver multiple slower balls. Usually they have their core delivery, and that's about all. The cutters are not quite as easy to pick. Instead of the fingers in front of the ball, you see sideways hand movement. The leg cutter has come back into fashion for T20 bowlers over the last few years, basically because it moves away from right-handers. It's probably the most subtle of these three deliveries, but you can see the hand twisting like someone quietly trying to open a door. And because the leg cutter has the least revolutions on the ball, it needs to be the most well disguised. A bad leg cutter can just be a bad slow ball, not a bad slower ball. But you can still see fingers are to one side of the ball, which is a sign that the bowler isn't delivering seam up, and that the side he is ripping the ball on will tell you which way it will go once it bounces. And the other one here is the off cutter, the most famous of the two cutters. It is the most used slower ball in cricket by a huge margin. While the leg cutter is a delicate delivery that can go wrong, the off cutter is about easy enough for any seamer to bowl. The fingers go on the opposite side to a leg cutter, and depending on the bowler, the wrist can often break as well. And unlike the leg cutter, the ball often has a lot of revolutions, meaning it gives you a bit of an idea as well. My guess is that the off cutter is bowled around 65% of all slower balls. The fingers come out the other side of the ball, the wrist breaks, and the ball goes up from the hand just a little bit with the seam spinning around. There is also a version where some bowlers don't use their thumb. It's not really a sexy ball like the other three. It's cricket's greatest spoiler, designed to deflate the ball and make hitting very hard. It was developed just a few years before the back of the hand delivery, and it's actually quite similar in that its origins are based in spin bowling again. West Indian Franklin Stevenson was playing some league cricket in England, and he was being overbowled, as most overseas players tend to be, and when he was tired, he would bowl off spin. That gave him a bit of an idea, and later he merged the two for the slower ball. Interestingly enough, we now have other bowlers who bowl even more like fast spinners than Stevenson did, with Mustafizur Rahman maybe being the most famous. And you have some bowlers who don't put many revs on the ball, and then you have bowlers like Mustafizur and Dwayne Bravo who put incredible rev on the ball. It is almost impossible not to pick their slower ball. And in some cases for Bravo and Mustafizur, it can be an incredibly slow ball again. But the thing is, if they were just slow, they wouldn't work. It's all the revolutions that make them work. And if anything, there seems to be more slower balls in T20 cricket than ever before. I would actually say it's the batters who have changed. The scoops and ramps were completely taking over only a few years ago. But as bowlers deliver more of these slower balls, and the ability to produce one when they see the batter move, it's very hard to ramp a slow ball no matter which one is bowled. There are essentially four major different slower balls. The perfect one, of course, would be a delivery that is slower, not picked, dips, bounces and deviates, but that's almost impossible. Most of the best change-up bowlers work with one or two of these as their strength. Some are very slow and do a lot. Some are still moving but do a little. There is no one slower ball. Just many different balls that, I don't know, aren't that fast.